If you're building a WeWeb app on top of a Supabase backend, you may be aware that your table of users in Supabase is in a private schema, an auth schema. And if you want a user to be able to update the profile of another user, that's not possible as is. Supabase's recommended approach is to create a profile table in the public schema that is synced to the users table in the auth schema so that when a new user signs up, a profile record is also created, which is linked to the users table. And that way, with the profiles in the public table, you can allow an admin user, for example, to update the information from another user. In this video, we'll show you how. In Supabase's documentation, you can find some of this information in authorization, managing user data, and towards the end of the article, we're going to look at the advanced techniques, which is using a trigger so that when a user signs up, and so user is added to the users table in the auth schema, we also create a record in the profiles table of our public schema. Let's have a look at our Supabase project. So by default, when you create a project in Supabase, you have an auth schema with a users table. And here we already have four users because we're already signed up and we see there's an email field. And there's also this field raw underscore user underscore meta underscore data, which is a JSON with information about the user. In this case, the user signed up with a provider with their Google account. And if I copy the cell content and paste it here, I can see the information that is available. So sub, I have a name, I have an email, I also have a picture and a full name, I have an avatar URL, a provider ID, custom claims. So potentially I might want to get this information, for example, or get the user's avatar. And by default, when you create a project in Supabase, you will not have a profiles table in the public schema. The users table will be in the auth schema and protected. But what we can do is first create a profiles table, then create a trigger to listen when there's a new user created in the users table of the auth table. And third, create a function that when that trigger happens, it populates information from the new user in the auth table to a new profile in the public schema. In order to do this, there are several ways. The quickest way is to go to the SQL editor, Quickstart, and User Management Starter. So what does this say? This is SQL. You don't need to be proficient in SQL, but it helps to try to understand what's going on. I am not proficient in SQL, but there's still a lot of English words and a lot of logical way of presenting the information. So hopefully I can understand and you can understand what's going on. So first in gray are comments. So this is not code. This is a description of what is happening. The first thing that's happening, this section here is saying, create a table that's called profiles, and the ID of each record should be a reference to the users table in the auth schema. And that will be a primary key. I want several columns. I want a timestamp that will be called updated underscore at. I want a username. It will need to be unique. And in Supabase, if you want a field to be unique, you need to add a constraint. So here I have a constraint that says the username length needs to be three or more. So I will have a username column in this profiles table. I will have a full underscore name column, an avatar URL text. And actually, I don't care about having a website. I'd like an email address.
So I'll just change that. So this first block of code will create the profiles table for me in the public schema. I could do this manually using the Supabase UI with a new table, and then I could completely do that manually. I would just have to make sure that the foreign key is related to the user's table. That would be the most important. But for the purposes of this video, we'll do everything in the SQL editor. So the second block of code, so to speak, is setting up row level security. So by default, when you create a new table in Supabase, you want to enable row level security. If you don't, it means that everybody will be able to see the data, update the data, create new records, or delete records. So you don't want that. You want to make sure you enable row level security, but once you've enabled row level security, if you don't do anything, if you don't create any policies, then nobody will be able to see any record, any data. Nobody will be able to update or create or delete anything. So you need to enable security, but you also need to create policies that tell Supabase what people can and cannot do on that table. So here we're saying, basically enable row level security on this profiles table. And then we create three policies. One, all three, by the way, on the profiles table. The first one is saying that everybody should see, should be able to see the profiles. Maybe you'll want to change this later and only allow authenticated users to view this all the profiles, or to allow all users to only see their own profiles. You can adjust this later, but this policy is saying public profiles are viewable by everyone. This policy here is saying when you are trying to insert a profile, make sure it's your own profile. So here we're checking that the UID of the user in the auth schema matches the ID of the profile in the profiles table. And it will, because here we have this condition. And finally, we have a third policy saying that we are allowing update if the user is trying to update the profile with the ID of that matches the ID of the user who is currently authenticated. All right, and again, this we could create manually in Supabase. I will show you later how you could edit them, but for now, let's do it like this. Now, this block here is about creating a trigger, like listening for the event of a new user being created in the users table of the auth schema, and using that trigger to go through a function that creates a profile in the profiles table. So here we have that function that says insert inside the profiles table of the public schema. You want to update these three columns. So we have ID, full name, avatar URL, and we said earlier we also wanted the email. And we have to tell the function which values we should input in the profiles table. So we want the ID of the new user's record that was created. We also want the full name from the raw user metadata. Let's see if we had it here. So yeah, we have full name. So inside that object, we want the value of this key, full underscore name. So we'll have to call raw underscore user underscore metadata underscore data, as we saw here. And we're saying we want the full name, and we also want the avatar URL. And in my users table in the auth schema, I also have an email field, so I can say new email. And this is saying that after a new user, a new record is created in the users table of the auth schema, For each row, we want to execute the handle underscore new user function, which we wrote here, which is this one. And finally, here we have information about how to set up storage. We don't need to do this for the purposes of this video. So let's keep it at that. We will run this and see what happens. Let's run it. It's a little bit scary, but we will say, okay, execute query. And it says success. All right, that's a good sign. So now let's go to our table editor. Now we see we have a profiles table. It's empty because we haven't signed up. We haven't created a new record in the user's auth table. And if we have a look at our database, we see the profiles table here. If we have a look at authentication, we see that in the policies, if we go to the profiles table, we have the three policies that we created. So here, for example, we could decide to change this policy, or we could decide to create a new one. We could start from a template. So everything that we did in the SQL editor, we could have done here. We could have created the policies here. And Supabase do have a few templates, like allowing insert access for authenticated users only, for example, or allowing update access based on a user's email. If you're not familiar with SQL, I can only recommend you to explore the topic and try learning with the Supabase community. That will be helpful to help you write the policy that suits your needs. And here in the database, we also have our new trigger, the onAuth user created. So after insert, so you can create the trigger manually. You would need to say, okay, in the user's auth, when there's an insert, and you could do an update. For example, if you want users to be able to update their user's record in the auth schema, and you want to update the new information in the profiles table, that's possible with an update trigger. In our case, we created an insert trigger after the event, so after someone signs up, creates a record in the user's table and for every row. And then the function that we triggered was the function handle new user. So we won't confirm because it already exists. And here we have our functions, and we have this handle new user function that says, okay, these are the four columns that I want to update in my profiles a table, and I want the values to correspond to this. And by the way, this needs to be in exactly the same order as this. So if I had new email here, then the email value would go in the full name column, which is not what I want. So again, I will cancel. And let's test this. Let's go to our WeWeb project and test this. So I have a signup workflow here, so let's just try choice plus video at weweb.io. I will say, it is not my nickname, but hey. All right, and here, if I go on my workflow, I will test it here and see what happens. So let me test this. All right, it seems like it worked. In Supabase, let's have a look at our auth schema in the users table. Choice plus video was created here. And if I go to my user metadata, I have the nickname JK. All right. And now if I go to my profiles table, I only have the email address. Why is that? I actually didn't map anything for the username. So if I go to my function, handle new user, I could say I also want update the username column. And in that case, it will be part of the new raw user metadata. And it will be nickname. There we go. Let's confirm this. And let's go back to WeWeb, and this time I will say video 2. Let's sign up again. There we go. Now I have my username. So it's called username in the profiles table, but in the users table, in the metadata JSON, we see it's called nickname. So that's why we, in our function, we mapped the nickname key of the metadata to the username column in our profiles table.
That's it. That's how you can create a user profile table in the public schema of your Supabase backend and populate that table with new users every time a new user is created in the users table of the private auth schema. You want to ensure you add the policies you want so that users can update their own profile, or maybe you want to add a policy so that users with an admin role can update someone else's profile. You may also want to trigger a new function when a user updates their user record in the auth schema. The logic will be very similar, but will need to be adapted to your specific use case.